had to reduce the volume because this opening and main menu are super loud.
Really?
Yeah.
For some reason.
What are you doing over here, Pippi?
Please insert us.
That is so loud. I mean, yes. Yeah, that's fine. Look at how it's coming across. Okay. That doesn't help. Yeah, I know. This view is always better than this view. I don't know why. That is so darn loud. Okay, we're gonna have to import and then.
Your character has been successfully imported.
Paladin, yes. Oh, we have some extra points. We'll do our yakking. When it stops, this guitar stops screaming at us. We have a magic stat now. I think because of how this game works with paladin abilities. So we could crank that up or put our 100 points to throw into things.
Put like half of it in magic.
Hello?
Maybe they just put it all in magic.
We should put some in.
It would take all of our points to get climbing.
Stealth, maybe?
We're not
sneaks. We're fighters. We're honorable. Princess, you are sleeping. Thank you.
Let's put some into.
You can always raise your luck because it's hard to grind that.
Yeah.
You can't directly increase your honor.
What if we do half luck, half magic?
Right.
Chill.
Oh. Thank you.
You awaken from nightmares of flying and falling. You find yourself in this strange place, the only illumination, an eerie green glow. You've lost your weapons and the contents of your backpack somewhere during the journey. All you have are the clothes and armor on your back. This leaves you with four burning questions. Where are you? How did you get here? Who brought you here? And how in blazes can you get out of here? Nope. Make that five burning questions. What city did your luggage end up in this time?
Whew. All right, now that we can hear ourselves think, adjust further more if need be. All right, we're here to continue our quest for glory. This one is fully voiced, at least on the CD version, which we're effectively playing, so I don't have to yak so much. Now these guys, you missed out on Quest for Glory 3, and they thought about, hey, can we watch the recordings? Like, well, it's not a very long game, but still a few hours, and when are we going to sit and watch a few hours of our own recordings? So, quick summary, there's not really a lot from 3 that you need to know carrying forward. It's high level, what happened is, after you became Prince of Shapir at the end of 2, a little bit of time passed, you're bored with royal life, you're not really meant for it, you're getting kind of antsy. Well, Rakish gets a call, well, not like a call, but he is summoned back to his homeland of Tarna. Ahura goes with him, because that is also her homeland, and you go with him because you're eager to get back to adventuring, and he is your paladin mentor, right? What's going on is there's Rakish's people, the Lion Tars, who live in Tarna. Uhura's people are the Simbani, they live out on the savannah. And there's another tribe a little farther out. They live in the jungle called the Leopard Men. And they and the Simbani kind of go back and forth a lot in history. They've always been at odds just because they have different values. The Leopard Men are magic users, and the Simbani are distrustful of magic users, and they tend with herds, and they are attuned with the land kind of thing. Well, apparently, the Leopard Men have... The Simbani believe that the Leopard Men stole their Spear of Death as a totem for their tribe. Quick pause here. Alright, so anyway, they also have come into possession of the Drum of Magic, which is the Leopard Men totem. If I remember right, something about like the guy, some Simbani warrior like chased after him, was found dead as though he had gone to get it or something, and it was on him. The Liontar sent out it was a multi-racial group, but it was headed by, or sent by the Liontars from Tarna, sent out a group called a peace mission toward the Leopard Men to talk to them and try to get these guys to settle down. That mission was attacked, and there was one survivor who made it back to Tarna, and Rikisha's daughter was one of the delegates who did not come back. So now the Liontars want to go to war, the Simbani want to go to war, and you're there to kind of help try to get in touch with the Leopard Men and figure out why everyone's mad at each other and how you can broker a peace. In the end, what is really going on is that there is a demon wizard who is trying to bring a horde of demons into the land. It's the same demon wizard that injured Rikish and hampered him. That wound that is not fully able to heal, that's why he wasn't able to fight and help you in number two. Because of that guy. Well, he's back trying to bring a horde of demons in. That's why they want to start a war. And you and a group of... A ragtag group of friends, as it so often happens, are able to unite and take down the demons. Such a really cool scene where you all fight like demonic doppelgangers of yourselves. But you stop the demon wizard, send them back. The demons are gone, and... you begin to celebrate with your friends. You start, there's this energy kind of pulsing around you and you're gyrating, and you get pulled away, magically summoned, and the last screen of three is a crystal ball looking thing that shows you inside it, and there's a dark Arabic man and a hooded figure looking over you, and now you end up here. I'm gonna move, actually. And we can let Squirrel take the first turn here.
For those of you who didn't hear over the beginning music, we put 50 more stat points into luck and 50 more into magic.
So last time, you did a parser interface last time, so I'll do a quick overview. These are you have your basic ways to interface, walking, looking at things, touching things, talking to people or things, I guess. This is a sub-menu which allows you to activate running, sneaking, the sleep menu, check what time it is.
I have no idea what time it is. Neither sun nor stars shine in these caves, and you feel totally disoriented.
This is your magic menu, which has your paladin ability of healing. You can right-click to cycle through those things. This is your last inventory item used. It will show up in here. Your inventory currently consists of your money pouch, which has one crown in it. I don't know how you picked that up. And you have your plate mail armor. You can get descriptions by looking in there. Here are your settings. You're going to want to move that speed up a little bit. You can probably go high detail. I'm not sure what that does. And your saving and all that is all over here.
Alright.
This game does have a fine manual that I do recommend you guys read or look at, and we can reference if we have questions.
You stumble and fall over the ancient petrified corpse.
You're dead already.
As you pick yourself up, you discover a dagger and some coins in the dried out dead body. It isn't going to use them anymore, so take them.
succeeded by falling.
This does not.
So I do recommend you guys check that out. YouTube boys. It's actually one of the better manuals, from what I remember. It's full of all kinds of information about the land, the monsters, the history. As copy protection, and it's something we will need to refer to it at some point. And also describes the kind of wonky battle system, but we can otherwise deal with that when the battle comes up. Although it is real time. But
it's a rotted ancient corpse, half buried cave. Find 30 assorted copper and gold coins.
Irritating how the narrator's voice's volume fluctuates a lot.
Nothing happened.
I kind of figured that out.
What's this? The altar feels strangely warm to your touch, but leaves a deeper chill somewhere within you. This is some kind of altar to the Dark One. The top is covered with sand. Torch holders flank the altar to provide light for nameless rites and unspeakable rituals. It doesn't say much.
Well, then what does it say?
You are in a large cave, dimly lit by glowing lichen on the walls. Strange, irregular outcroppings of stone rose from the ground, looking like the skeleton of some enormous beast. Here and there, petrified human bodies seem to grow half in, half out of the floor of the world. It seems to be a kind of stone valve acting as a door to the passageway beyond. The valve won't budge. If you had a bit more light, maybe you'd be able to see how to open it.
Yeah.
That didn't do anything useful.
It's a good thing these guys, they have these bodies in here with all their useful stuff they dropped before.
Oh, yeah. Let me try and find one to loot.
That didn't do it.
That
didn't. Did that one?
I don't know. Maybe it's a different one.
You find nothing else. A brief search reveals a piece of hard gray rock, mm-hmm. cake, and some coins. 3 crowns and 13 copecks. There's nothing in. Put the torch. Strike sparks off the flint using your dagger. Torch soon begins to burn, almost as if by magic. You take the torch.
Oh, geez. Come back there, unless there's anything else you'd seem.
It won't pick up the
that we need to do in here.
You see anything or want to check anything out?
Oh, what's this mean?
That didn't do anything.
Can you explore up over there?
That didn't do
anything. I think it means about walking.
You
can only follow the spine there.
That didn't do anything.
Yes.
Force the sphincter open with your dagger and pass through. You've made it into a large chamber. Stone valves, like the one you just passed through, apparently block 3 other passageways. There is a huge stone altar in the center of the room and an exit to the south. The altar feels strangely warm to your touch. Leaves a deeper chill somewhere.
Yeah. Oh, what's this? I think we need those.
Gratefully retrieve the shield and battered sword from the dead warrior. Hope that they will serve you better than they did their last owner.
Do you think you'll we'll encounter,
That didn't do.
I think we'll encounter a battle in this starting thing. Okay, which passage do we choose?
That one.
This one?
Yes.
Should be able to write, just hand on it, he'll walk over.
Well, I don't think so.
Straighten out your jacket and retie your boots. Appearances. Truck.
Yep.
Try as you might, stone valve will not open. This isn't the right time.
Okay, try that one.
Try as you might.
And probably the same with this one.
Try as you might. As you approach the exit, you are confronted by two flying creatures.
Down.
They have bat wings and spider-like bodies.
So you click on different parts of the screen to do different things. So like if you click in front of you, click only. Like click up at them to attack, and then click to move forward, click high to jump. There are ways to like duck and other things. And then, you can also right click to do a different kind of attack. Try to step closer. Like move your cursor down to like in front of you, so you step a little closer there and attack.
That's not what I'm trying to do.
There you go.
No.
Click on the battery.
I'm trying. It won't.
Try right clicking. There you go.
In a bitter battle, you are better than the battles.
You're dumb.
You kick some butt too. Something deadly lies in wait nearby.
That's your spidey sense going off.
A massive pillar fills much of the upper ledge.
Why is this
deep
less
pit
difficult?
Fills most of this hallway. A rope bridge spans the narrow stretch of the chasm.
Why is this what?
This looks more like a cartoon drawing than the...
You cautiously test the rope before crossing.
Feels
as though it's firmly anchored on both
ends of
the cabin.
It seems more like a drawing that somebody would do instead of an actual game.
Fly across?
Yeah, sure, try.
It would be nice work if you could get it, but you don't know a flying spell. The best you can do is to levitate.
Oh, because you have points in magic,
down,
it thinks that
unless you can find a way
it
to
gives you some magic
help.
User options. You don't actually know a levitate spell.
We just know healing.
Because you're not actually a wizard.
Okay, do we want to try and... take the rope? Or cross handle? I don't think we should cross over.
Yeah, let's take the rope.
A rope might be useful, but it's firmly attached on both ends. You think about cutting it loose, then decide that you may have to come back this way again.
So I guess we cross.
You are so exhausted.
And that batter fight took a lot.
Just barely made it.
I guess because of all the jumping you did.
I guess. It wasn't intentional.
It looks
I
like
know.
There's a passageway
there. I know that. I'm just saying, it's what happened.
This is the weirdest thing ever.